when you create a variable of a structure, all the elements in the structure are in a contiguous memory location, right? So if the structure is of say 20 bytes, then all these 20 bytes are packed together and each element gets its share of memory depending on its data type. For example, the present structure, as you are seeing it on the screen, has got two elements. One is the data and the second is the pointer, which I am calling it as link. Link is the name of the pointer. So the data, assume that because being an integer takes 4 bytes, so the pointer also takes 4 bytes. Not that the data is of integer type, therefore the pointer is going to take 4 bytes. Pointer as such is the address. Pointer as such is the address. So this address takes the same memory which is required for storing any integer value. Therefore, I am saying 4 bytes. So totally the block is of 8 bytes. So when I am saying the first is a pointer which stores the base address of this block of 8 bytes, right? First is a pointer which stores the base address of this block of 8 bytes. Now the first node is created somewhere in the heap. The second node which gets created, not necessarily it will be immediately next to it. It may be any other address in the heap. For example, if this first node is at the base address of this first node, let's assume that it is 1000. This base address could be 2000. It could be 2000. So we create a isolated node and store its base address in the link of the previous node. Similarly, each of the node stores the base address of the next node. And you must take care of this, that the last node of in the chain is identified when the address which is stored in the pointer called as link is null. The fact that this pointer is null, it means that that is the last node in the chain. That's the last node in the chain. Okay, so this is what diagrammatically we should keep it in mind, and we should start coding for it. So this link list has four nodes in it, each with a link to the next node, and this link is named as link itself. The last node has a link to the special value called as null value. Otherwise, there is no way of identifying whether we have reached to the last node, because if we want to display the data of each node, we should stop once the last node is reached. So if the link is not equal to null, keep on displaying and moving forward to the next node. So that's the reason why we store the null value. There is also another special pointer called as first, which points to the first link in the chain. What is so important about the first link in the chain? The fact that we need to know the starting point of the chain. The endpoint is known with the null as the value in the pointer. So also we should know which is the first node in the chain. That's the reason why we declare a special pointer which only shows the base address of the first node. The key part, as I told you, a structure which holds the data for each node, most importantly the pointer to the next node, right? And do not get away with an idea that only two elements, that is data and pointer to the next node, are only stored. You can add as many elements in the node as per your requirement. For example, I can have a array of characters of size 20. When I can store the age of the student in another element called as int age, then I have a struct node pointer next, right? I have not added struct, but the syntax should have struct node pointer next. So this is the pointer pointing to the next node. And then we have to terminate the structure with a semicolon. It is exactly same as you have learned in the last semester of creating a structure, right? So what we do is that we declare one more variable of node type, right? One more variable of node type, and which is a pointer, right? Node is what is the name, is the name of your structure is equal to null. So present to start with, when there are no nodes in the linked list, the first is having a null value. First is having the null value. So that's how we build the linked list and come to the last node in the series. Okay. So to start with, we'll make an assumption that we want nodes which is capable of storing an integer element called as data, and the second element is the self-referential structure, which is struct node next, right? So as I told you, before you start creating a linked list, singly linked list, the first and the foremost thing is that we initialize this first with null value, because we do not know that how many nodes are going to get added. As and when the first node gets added, this first will start pointing to the very first node. Okay, so that's the reason why a small portion of the main I have written over here, and as the class progresses, we'll write the entire program, and I want you also simultaneously to activate your C editor and start coding as and when I tell you to code. Okay, do not code it now, because this is only a portion of the program. Okay, if you start coding it now and then you will say, sir, it's not working. So when I start to tell you, when I ask you to start, that's the point you start coding and compiling. Okay, now what I have done, as I told you in the previous class, malloc is a built-in function which takes a single parameter, size of struct node, right? Malloc returns a void pointer. That void pointer, we are typecasting it to struct node type, right? That void pointer, we are typecasting it to struct node pointer. And cur is the current, short form of current, which is a temporary name to an isolated node, right? So as you start building it, current is a pointer, cur is equal to struct node this. So what is going to happen is going to create a block of say 20 bytes as per our requirement, in which the first element is going to store data and the second element is going to store link, right? So the base address of this get stored into your cur, which is a pointer of struct node type, So what we'll do is to know the procedure of adding, a node at the end of the list, right? To add a node at the end of the list. Now the simplest way is to assume that it has to be added to the end of the list, right? But that does not mean that we cannot add a node anywhere in the linked list. We can very much add the node at the beginning of the linked list, in the middle of the linked list, and at the end of the linked list. I am thinking that the easiest way is to add a node at the last. So firstly, we declare the space for a pointer item and assign a temporary pointer to it, right? This is done using the malloc statement as you are seeing it over here, which is a memory allocation function. Okay, so graphically I would like to show it to you that we have created a memory area making a provision for these two, right? Now presently the first, there's a pointer first, is also pointing to the very first, and last is also pointing to the first. So the very start point is that we should make a provision to store the base address of the first node, to store the base address of the current node, and to store the base address of the last node. So in all there are three pointers which come very very handy as far as dealing with the linked list, singly linked list. Yeah, this last and first, if you write a statement over here, last is equal to struct node pointer last is equal to char. Struct node pointer last is equal to char, then the address which is stored in char will also get stored in last. Similarly, if you write a statement called as first, a struct node pointer first, assignment operator char semicolon, then whatever is the base address which is stored in char will be assigned to first also. Yes, Shuttle, are you okay? The size, yeah. So if it is struct node pointer, you are asking the size. What is the size of the pointer? The pointer pointer is not allocated any size, Atal. Pointer by definition stores the base address of a variable of same data type. The size, if you consider the size of the pointer in this, there it is 4 bytes. There it is 4 bytes. So this 4 bytes plus this 4 bytes, that's how I am saying that the total block memory is 8 bytes. Yes, Atal? If you consider the structure as it is in the code, we have int data and struct node pointer next, right? So since this takes 4 bytes and this takes 4 bytes, so total area for this block is 8 bytes. Correct. We did not initialize at the beginning, but with the diagrammatically what I am trying to show is that if we write a statement over here, struct node last is equal to char, struct node first pointer first is equal to char, then your char, your first and the last will start pointing to the same base address. Okay, so adding a node at the end of the list. Let us see how the algorithm is. First, we declare the space for the pointer item and assign a char pointer to it, means a temporary pointer. This is done using the malloc statement, right? So this is how the complete code for your inserting at the end, what? Inserting a node at the end of the linked list. So very first statement, what we are doing, we are prompting to the user, enter the next element, means we are asking the user to enter some value. Suppose the user has entered 10, right? That 10, if you see the second statement, I am declaring a temporary pointer called as char, and allocating that 8 bytes base address of the 8 bytes of a block. Now scanf, cur arrow pointer data, we have to use an arrow pointer to access the element of the structure because cur is a pointer. If cur is a normal variable of the structure, to access the element we have to use the dot operator. But because cur is a pointer, we are using an arrow operator. So this 10 value gets stored in your area which is allocated for data. For example, as you are seeing it in the diagram, so this data will be storing the value 10, and this cur is going to store the base address of this block of 8 bytes of memory. Now coming to the third statement, correct. Yes, Atal. Last is equal to cur. It means that suppose cur is storing a value 1000, last also will store the value 1000. Right. So coming to the third statement, fourth statement, cur of link is equal to null. So what we are doing, this is the link, and in this link we are storing a null value. So this null value gets stored over here. And remember that this is an isolated pointer. Now, what is the problem in front of us? The problem in front of us is that there is already a linked list which is existing, and a new linked list we want to add at the end, right? So let us see that the already existing linked list, and that existing linked list is as I told you earlier also, the last node in the existing linked list is pointed to null, right? When we call this function, the statement 1 to statement 4 has created an isolated node. So this isolated node has got created, and so far I have not come to this particular statement. Up to first 4 statement only we have created an isolated node somewhere in the heap, right? Now when I come to the fifth statement, last of link, that is last is over here, last of link, and I am assigning cur. Okay, so what happens if this cur is 1000, this null is going to get replaced with value 1000, right? So this null, this link starts pointing over here. Now there is one more job which is left. Presently the last is here, but because we added one more last node in the linked list, we should advance this last over here. So what do we do? Last is equal to cur, right? Presently the last was storing this base address. Assume that this base address was 500. This last was storing base address 500, but that base address 500 we have to advance it to 1000, because we have made an assumption that the base address of this block is 1000. Hello, can you hear me? How come then? Yes. Audible. Okay, somebody commented that no voice. I don't know how. Okay, most of you are able to hear. I'll take it as there is some local issue with Sheikh Obed. Sheikh Obed, can you hear me now? Sheikh Obed, some local issue with you. Hello. Yeah, so let's go move further. So that is how. Now the last point which was left, that is the last statement, that is the statement number 6, last is equal to cur. When this is executed, this particular last is going to take this position, right? This last is going to take this position. So every time we should ensure that the last pointer is pointing to the last node, and the first pointer should point to the first node. And in between, if we want a temporary node to be created, call it as cur. Okay, so this is the algorithm which we had discussed in the last class also. I am repeating again. Now the same thing, but now the problem is little different. The problem is that we have to insert a node at the beginning. We have to insert the node at the beginning. Okay, so we'll the first two steps, or first 1, 2, 3, cur. We are building the cur, and cur of link is equal to first, right? Cur of link is equal to first. So first and cur both are standing here. Okay. Now what we have done? We have created an isolated node. We have created an isolated node with this and ampersand cur of data. So we have given some value, say value is -10, right? Make an assumption that previously already one linked list is existing. One linked list is existing, and as I told you earlier, the first pointer of the existing linked list is pointing to the first, right? And it has got one more node which is pointing to the last. So existing linked list has got two nodes, with the last node link pointing to none. Okay, so what we do, cur of link is equal to first. Now what is cur of link is equal to first? Now presently cur is some isolated value, and this we are connecting it to the very base address of the first one, right? So in the previous example, the last was standing here, so we moved the last here. Now exactly opposite has happened. The first should come back one step, right? So first is equal to cur. So when we make first is equal to cur, the first pointer will come and stand it over here, and that's how we'll be able to connect a newly created node, and not only connect but make it as the first node in the chain. Those students who have not understood the inclusion of a node at the beginning, please raise your hand. Please come to the chat window and ask a specific thing. If you understood, don't come to the chat window. If you are not understood, and at which step you are not understood, if you can put it in the chat window, I'll be able to explain you again. Okay, as the chat window is silent, so let's progress to the next step. Now the next step is what? Displaying the list of the node. For example, you have say 4 nodes in the linked list. So I want to see the data in each of the nodes starting from. So algorithm is like this. Just set a temporary pointer to point to the start pointer. And which is the start pointer? As I told you, you should always have the first pointer pointing to the first. You should always have the last pointer pointing to the last. And you should have a temporary pointer, which presently we are calling it as CUR, current, right? Set this current temporary pointer to the first pointer. Okay. If the pointer points to null, when can it point to null? When there are no nodes. So initially your cur, your first, your last, all are nulls. Means what? That is the state where there are absolutely 0 nodes in the linked list. So we cannot overrule this possibility. So if the pointer points to null, that is what cur, it starts pointing to null, then display that it is not having any nodes. Otherwise, display the details. For example, display the data of the node pointed to by the start pointer, then make this temporary pointer to advance to the next node, right? Do not disturb the first, but advance the temporary pointer to the next node, right? Because first always should remain pointing to the first node, last always should remain pointing to the last node. Okay, if you keep this in your back of your mind, you can handle the linked list very, very comfortably. And this process, this particular process of jumping the temporary pointer to the next, you should keep on going up to two, up to step two, till the time you encounter that with null. And when will you encounter null? As I told you, the last pointer is the pointer whose link is null. Okay, so with this algorithm, let us see the code. Go through this code. I'll explain it with the diagram. Okay. So, presently the first pointer is pointing to the first. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 nodes. And this is the last node because this is having the null value. So, what I do, I execute the first statement. So, what I do, I bring this cur is equal to first. So, this cur and first presently at this particular point, if we freeze the code at this particular point, my first and cur are pointing to the base address of the first node, right? Then a new line character while cur not equal to null. The fact that the first is pointing to the base address of the first node, it won't be null. So the while condition is true. If the while condition is true, we are putting the print statement cur of data. So if this is 10, the 10 gets printed. If this is 10, then 10 gets printed. Then the next step, cur is equal to cur of link. Cur is equal to cur of link. So this cur which is pointing to this base address, and this link is having the base address of the second node. Assume that the second address is 2000. So here it is 2000. So this 2000 gets copied to cur. When it gets to 2000, the cur is going to advance here, right? So this cur pointer is going to have the base address as 2000. Now again we go in the while loop, cur not equal to null. Because cur is having 2000, it is not null, true. So it's going to print this data, assume that it is 20. So 20 gets printed, right? Cur is equal to cur of link. We are again advancing the cur to the next base address, right? Again we are at the top of the loop, right? Assume that cur is 3000, not cur is 3000, which is not null. And we print say 30. Again we advance it. So again we advance it. Again assume that it is 4000. 4000 is not equal to null. We print say 40. Again advance it, right? Advance it. Since base address is 5000, 5000 is not null. So we print 50. So we have printed 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Again we advance cur is equal to cur of link. Now cur of link is null, right? So what we encounter over here, cur of null not equal to null, null not equal to null, which is false. So since it is false, we come out of the loop, and that's the end of the function also. So we terminate and go back to the calling function. So this is how we can display each and every node values. In this case, we are taking data as the value, but there could be more than that. There could be name, there could be age, there could be marks obtained in the more subjects. So everything which is there in a particular node can be displayed. Anybody who has not understood this display, please come to the chat window and ask. anybody who has not understood the display function, please come to the chat window and I can explain. So how does the cur advance to the next node? Okay, Nag Venkata. See, Nag Venkata, correct, cur data is base address, you are right, cur data is base address. So what is the in this link? The base address of the next node, the base address of the next node, right? So assume that the base address is 1000, the base address is 2000, this is 3000, this is 4000, and this is 5000. Okay, so what is over here? 1000. What is here? 2000, 3000, 4000, and null, right? Sorry, not 1000. Here it is 2000, 3000, 4000, 5000, and null, right? So cur is equal to cur of link. Presently, cur is pointing to 1000, right? Cur is equal to cur of link what? Cur arrow operator link. Cur arrow operator link. What is it going to pick up? Arrow operator is going to pick up the value over here. And what is the value over here? The base address, that is 2000. Yes, so it advances to 2000 over here because cur is presently over here. Cur arrow operator link, right? So it's going to pick up from here, it's going to pick up 3000 and cur becomes 3000. Again, here it is 4000. It's going to pick up 4000 and come here. Now here it is 5000, right? Again, it's going to come and pick up 5000. Now, having picked up 5000, we are again saying cur is equal to cur of link. Now, what is cur of link? Cur of link is null. So, in the while loop, null not equal to null becomes false. Naga Venkat, is that clear? Akashdeep struct node, all this cur first last are all struct node types, then only they can store the base address of the node which is of struct node type. Okay, fine. So once again it will get revised when we are actually, when I make you to write the code. Okay, now third and the last part is deleting a node. So we have seen how to insert a node at the end, we have seen how to insert a node at the beginning, we have seen how to display the data of each node, and the fourth thing which is left is to delete a node. So let us consider deleting the first node. So this is, assume that this is the linked list which we have, which is existing. First is pointing to the base address of the first node, the second node, third node, which happens to be the last node because the link is having null value. Okay, so what we do, the algorithm wise, we bring the cur to the first, right? We bring the cur to the first, means cur assignment operator first. Cur and first are pointers of struct node type. Therefore, we can write a statement cur assignment operator null first. कर असाइनमेंट ऑपरेटर फर्स्ट. नाउ व्हाट वी डू, वी विल एडवांस द फर्स्ट टू फर्स्ट ऑफ नेक्स्ट. आर यू गेटिंग दिस पॉइंट? प्रीवियसली द स्टेटमेंट विच वी हैव रिटन इज दैट कर असाइनमेंट ऑपरेटर फर्स्ट, नेक्स्ट स्टेटमेंट विल राइट फर्स्ट इज इक्वल टू फर्स्ट ऑफ नेक्स्ट. व्हाट इज फर्स्ट ऑफ नेक्स्ट? फर्स्ट ऑफ लिंक, राइट? फर्स्ट ऑफ लिंक, assume that this is 2000, so the first is going to advance over here, right? Now we are ready to delete this particular node. So the points which we should note is that first we free this node. You remember I gave you four built-in functions: one malloc, calloc, realloc and free, right? So we use the free function, we use the free cur. Free cur means what? This entire memory location is gone, right? This entire memory location is gone and this particular memory location vanishes. This particular memory location vanishes. But the point to be noted over here, students, is that before you use the free cur, ensure that the first has gone to correct node, right? Don't make the first statement itself. In this situation, suppose you make it's correct that we want to delete the first node, so you can simply say free cur. But what will happen? The moment you free cur, you have lost the address over here, right? And as I told you, every time you should store the address of the first node in the first, right? So before you execute free cur, ensure that the first has come to the present second. First has come to the present second, and then only you should free the cur, right? So now again you ask to free the cur. Now the first is standing here, right? So cur is equal to first. First is equal to first of link. Bring the first over here and then free cur, right? So that is how you should be able to plan it. That's how you should be able to plan, right? So see the code of this corresponding to what I said. Right. It is quite possible that there are no nodes in the linked list. So first obviously will be null. In that case, List is empty. When will I come to else part? When first is not null, right? When first is not null. So I come to the else part. So as I had told you, cur is equal to first. So I have brought this cur at first. Then what I do? First is equal to first of link, right? So I advance this first to the first of link, right? So first will come over here, right? Presently first and last, it can happen that there are only two nodes. So first and last will start pointing to the same memory location. Next step, what we have to do? We are supposed to delete this particular memory location. So next what we do? We cur of link is equal to null. Now a point about this. Cur of link is equal to null. So before you actually free this, you finish this off, you break this link, you remove whatever is the previous address over here, right? So make it null. So this point is getting covered. Cur of link is equal to null. So we have made this as null. The moment we make it as null, now this has become an isolated node, right? This is not a part of the chain, right? So the next step is what? Deleted element is cur of data, right? So before I actually come out of this function, on the screen I would like to tell my user that friend, the first node which was having 10 as the data has been deleted. So deleted element is 10, right? And finally I free cur. So when I free the cur, this gets out of the memory, right? So that is how you can delete the first node. As far as deletion of the node is concerned, if you have any questions, please come to the chat window. For those students, please, who have requested your faculty, you have stopped us by 1 week, right? This whole week, I am only devoting for you. So those students who have not understood linked list in unit 1, and those students who are absent for some reason, please utilize this particular session. Okay, Arshad. Right. Okay, let me take it to the... Suppose you have two nodes in the linked list. The first is pointing to the first and the last is pointing to the last. Right? So, first equal to equal to null is false. No, we cannot. Nag Venkat, when you free, the cur should have some memory. Cur should have some memory, isn't it? And why we are using this cur? Because on the screen, we would like to print to the user, give a confirmation to the user that I have deleted the node which was earlier first. Right? So without linking cur to null, of course we can delete it, as you are asking me, of course you can delete, but there are certain good practices. What are the good practices? That suppose this particular node is having some address, suppose it's having some address, the good practice say that before you poof off or before you delete the node, you ensure that it is made to null, right? It is just to follow the good practices, Nag Venkat, but without making it null, also we can delete it. Venkat Karthik, without making it null also we can remove it, but as good practices say that before you come out of the function, you ensure that all the memory locations are made clean. Otherwise, some memory locations will continue to have some garbage values. Right. So, the fact that first is having some base address, so this is false. So, it won't go to if, it will come to else. In the else part, we are already created one cur, which is a struct node pointer. Struct node pointer. So, first is equal to cur. So, I brought the first and cur at the same location. So if this is the base address of this first node is say 1000, so 1000 gets stored in first also, 1000 gets stored in cur also. Assume that the base address of the last node is 2000. So here it is presently 2000. Presently it is 2000. Next statement, first is equal to first of link. Right? The first was here. First is equal to first of link. What is here? Link is 2000. So first has become 2000. So first will come over here, right? First starts pointing to the base address of the second node, right? Now, next step, cur of link is equal to null. What we are doing? We are cutting this particular link. We are making it totally isolated and replacing the existing 2000 value with null, right? Existing 2000 value, we are making it null. Now, having done, we have absolutely broken the chain. So make this totally an isolated node, and now the next step is that suppose I write this statement here and print statement here, I'll be in trouble. Why? Because I have already freed the cur. Having freed the cur of pointer arrow operator data, it will say cur does not exist. So you will get an error. You will get an error. Therefore, before freeing it, what I'm doing, for the sake of the user, because see, ideally you should have more of a interactive program. More of a interactive program means what? The user, suppose you say delete the first node. Yes, you have deleted the first node. When the first node is deleted, something should come on the screen. Deleted the first node having the data is 10. So the user who is seeing your code
also get some kind of a confirmation, yes, when I press this key, the first node got deleted. Okay, for that reason, I'm saying deleted element is, and it will say current of data. Suppose this is 10, so deleted element is 10, and then I'm freeing it. When I free it, this goes out, and the first is standing here. Arshad, are you okay? Right. Anybody else? Any other doubt as far as delete is concerned? Deleting the first node. Okay. Now students, start writing the code. As you are seeing it on the screen, start writing the code. And in next 20 minutes, we should be able to complete the code. In next 20 minutes, we should be able to complete the code. All of you, do it on your personal dev plus editor. Do not use the online editor. Sometimes these online editors, they create issues. So do it on your personal dev C++ or Turbo C or whichever editor you have. Now, as you are doing it, let me explain. Struct node into data, struct node link, right? So this is a self-referential structure. So this is a pointing to a node of struct node type. Now, struct node pointer curl, pointer first, pointer last, temp1 and temp2, right? Temp1 and temp2 are again, very useful pointers. As we progress in the class, I will explain it to you. Same thing. See, what is the difference between struct node pointer link and struct node okay. The Yashatal, it is like this. Struct node pointer link. Struct node pointer link is a pointer. Link is a pointer of struct node type. Now coming to your second part. Struct node pointer curl. Right? It is one and the same. You are creating link as the name of the self-referential structure, and in the second case you are making cur as the name of the self-referential structure. There are two different names here, Shuttle. There is struct node pointer link and struct node pointer cur. In both these cases, link is the pointer of struct node type. And in the second case, cur is the pointer of struct node type. What is the confusion? Is there a confusion, Yashatan? Have I answered your question or you are asking something else? See, you are saying no, struct node pointer link means what? Link is a pointer of struct node type. Second part, you said struct node pointer cur. So cur is a pointer of struct node type. Both are. In the first case, the name of the pointer is link. In the second case, the name of the pointer is cur. Can you elaborate your question? Maybe that I am not understanding your question. It is something like int x comma y semicolon. So x and y both are the variables of integer data type. Now in this case, a structure is a user defined data type. So struct node link comma cur, also if you write link comma cur, both are the pointers of struct node type. Link is defined for some. That is correct. But see, when you write string struct node link inside the structure, so the structure has got two elements. The first element is data, and the second element is pointer to the next node, right? When you create a struct node pointer cur, right, it is going to store the base address. It's going to store the base address. Okay, let me explain it in this fashion. See, when I create a struct node, this structure has two elements. First element is data type, which is name is data. The second element is the pointer pointing to a memory location, which stores a struct node. That's for part number one. Right? Now coming to this statement. Struct node pointer cur. So you have declared a pointer which is cur. Name of the pointer is cur, which is capable of storing the base address of a struct node data type. Rohit, the hash alloc.h is for those students who are using Turbo C. Malloc function sometimes is not in hash include stdio.h, but in dev plus there is not required. In dev plus it is not required. In stdio.h you get malloc also. Yash Hattal. I do not know. I'm getting a feeling that still the doubt is continuing. I think when I do this create function, I have some explanation for this create function which is there on your screen with some animation. I'll be able to, I think, further talk about your doubt. Presently, I am getting a feeling that you are not clear about my explanation. Okay, just a minute. Let me explain this create function. Probably your doubt may get cleared. Now this particular create function, now before that I have created 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pointers of struct node data type. Then these are the prototypes: create, insert beginning, delete at the start, delete at the end, and display. Right? These are the functions which we are going to use in the complete code. Right? I hope students, I am not going to wait once I explain this. Right? I hope you have started typing in your personal editors. Do not compile it, but do not execute it. Right? Compile it, but do not execute, because we are not yet done with the complete code. Now create. Enter the first element, the prompt. Cur is equal to struct node pointer malloc. So I am creating a temporary pointer cur. Scanf cur of data. Right? And cur of link is equal to null. First is equal to cur. Last is equal to cur. So what we do to begin with in the main function I call the create function and create one isolated first node. In this isolated first node, what I do, I I create one cur, right? The cur is already there, which is a global variable. Since it is a global variable, this global variable is available for this create function, and this global variable is available for all the functions. For example, it is available for insert beginning, delete start, delete end, and display. Right? Therefore, we have put this structure and all these pointers in the global area. So here cur is equal to struct node malloc this thing. Cur of link is equal to null. Right? So this curve of link, I have put it as null. First is equal to curve. So make an assumption that this is 1000. So at the present, curve is having 1000, first is having 1000, and last is also having 1000. Right? From the main function, when I call the create function, all this thing has happened. An isolated very first node has got created. It has got a data value, say 10. The base address is 1000. And since this is the first node, so this is also the last node. So it is correct when first is also pointing here and last is also pointing here, because there is only one node. So that node, you call it first node, you are right. You call it last node, you are still right. Okay. Now, yes, shuttle. Right. So when you do this, this curve, as you would say, struct node curve type, curve is equal to this memory allocation happens. So because this curve is of struct node type, I can write this statement. So whatever a block of memory has got created, and say base address is 1000, that base address it is ready to receive. This is the first part of it. Now you ask me the different struct node link. Now this is your struct node link, isn't it? This is your struct node link. What is that struct node link? Now this struct node link, I am initializing it to null. So here I am storing presently null value. In the curve, I have stored 1000. In this location, I have stored null. Yes, shuttle. Are you able to? So let me go further. So we are done with the create function. Now let's go further and inserting the last node. So the name of the function is insert, as it was in the prototype. So start writing the code in your personal editor. And also keep listening to what I'm saying. I'm just prompting to the user, enter the next element, right? So curve are created, this curve are created, scanf curve of data, curve of link is equal to null, right? So an isolated node has got created, and the data is say 20, the data is 20, and this is null. Now, what is this insert function doing? This insert function is inserting the last node. This insert function is inserting the last node. So up to here and this step, what I have done, these four steps, what we have done, we have just created an isolated node, gave the value data here and null here. Then next step. So in the previous case, coming from the previous case, this curve was there. Now, the moment this thing happens, the curve value does not remain 1000, but the curve value is the new value. Students, are you getting this point? See, this is the previous state. When I called the create function, at the create function, this was the very first node. So, curve first, last, or here itself. Now, in this case, this is the present state. But when you execute these statements, when you execute this statement, or for example, when this statement is executed, this curve is no more going to point over here, but it is going to point to an isolated node, and it is going to have some data value, and its link is null. Students, are you confused? Are you able to visualize? Just now. Somebody who is not understood. Once we call the create function, and now we have called a function called as insert. Right? So previously this was the state. Now we want to insert the last node. When we want to insert the last node, first we have to create one isolated node. And that isolated node creation has happened in this. Now we have to link this existing first node to the newly created node at the end of the linked list, right? So next step, what we do? Yes, last is equal to last of char. Last is pointing here, and last of char is what? Last of link is equal to char. So this base address gets stored here. We are not Prajwal. We are not moving first of link is equal to char. That's also one way. But if we move that, the first will come to the second node. So we will ensure that first is always pointing to the first node. Therefore, last of link is equal to char. Right? What is the next step? Last of link is equal to char means what? This, which was null, now becomes some value. Right? Now we have to move this last so that it starts pointing to the last node. So last is equal to char. So this last is going to move from here and going to come over here. Again, Yash Atal, your doubt that now previously this was having null. Which one? First of link was having null. That first of link we have replaced with the base address of the isolated node, right? And this char is the value at the char. We have some different address of an isolated node. We can also free char after create function. Will it make any difference? No, it will not make any difference. In fact, you should create so that next time I call, the char is available with zero value. Lakshmi Shravya, you can free it also. Though I have not added that statement, but there is no harm in freeing the char. So I hope students are typing it also. I am not going to wait for you. Now, deleting node from the first. So a delete function, deleting node from the first under delete function. Please continue writing the code. Void delete first equal to null. Q is empty. This is correct. Q is empty. But presently first is pointing to some base address. So We come to the else block. So first is equal to char is equal to first. This char we are storing the first value. Then first is equal to first of link. We are advancing this first over here. Then char of link is equal to null. We are going to break this particular char of link with null value. Then we are printing that I have deleted, delete element is 10. Then I am freeing the char. Are you done with this? Please execute this code. Don't execute the code. Please complete this code. Delete function. So Lakshmi Shravya, here I have freed this char. And so also you can free the char in the previous insert function also. You can free this char in the insert function also. Okay. So let me proceed further. Deleting the last node. So for deleting the last node, right, we have to delete this particular last node which is having null value. As you know that how to identify the last node. Last node is identified when its link is having null value. Okay. Yes, Shuttle, what are you asking? Something null? Yes, Shuttle, is there any question regarding null? So, should I proceed further? Sneha, are you done? Okay. So now let's go to the deleting the last one. Now assume that these are the nodes which we have, first one, middle one, and the last node. We identify the last node and the link is having null value. So what we do, temp 1 and temp 2, I told you that temp 1 and temp 2 I will explain when I proceed. Okay, so presently we have a temporary node which is pointing to the first node, right? How do we do that? Like how char is equal to first, we say temp 1 is equal to first. Okay, we also create one more node, call it as temp 2, and this temp 2 also points to the first node, right? So presently temp 1, temp 2 and first, all these pointers are having the same base address. Assume that this is 1000, say this is 2000 and this is 3000. Okay, so 1000 base address is stored in temp 2, 1000 is stored in temp 1, 1000 is stored in first also. Now what I do, I ask, is temp 1 is equal to null, right? Is temp 1 is equal to null? If temp 1 is null, means what? This is the only node, right? So we have to pop it out. If it is not, like you are seeing in the diagram, then what I do, I advance temp 1 over here. How do I advance temp 1 over here? Temp 1 is equal to temp 1 of link. Temp 1 is equal to temp 1 of link. So temp 1 moves from here and temp 1 comes here. Then again I ask question, is temp 1 of link null? Is temp 1 of link null? If it is no, then what I do, I advance this temp 2 over here. If temp 1 is not null, I advance temp 2 here. Students, I hope you are understanding. If it is not null, I am advancing this over here. So from the temp 2 has come over here. Again, I advance this temp 1 to the next node. How? Temp 1 is equal to temp 1 of link. When I advance, when this is not null. So I bring temp 1 over here and I ask a question, that is temp 1 of link null? Is temp 1 of link null? Now in this case, temp 1 of link is null, true. When temp 1 of link is null, true, I do not advance this temp 2 to temp 2 of link. Right? Why? Because I want temp 2's link to be made null. Right? And free temp 1. Are you getting my? That's the reason why I am using two pointers. Is this algorithm understood? Anybody who has not understood why we are using temp 1 and temp 2. Sometimes this temp 2 is also called as a shadow pointer. Shadow pointer is what? A pointer which is just one step behind the temp 1 pointer. Okay. Yeah. Pay attention. Presently, temp 1 equal to first. Temp 2 is equal to first. So temp 1, temp 2 and first are all pointing at the base address. Then we ask question, is temp 1 of link not equal to null? True. We advance temp 1 over here. Again ask a question, is temp1 of link not equal to null? True. If this is true, then we advance temp2 over here. Okay. Now, temp1 of link not equal to null. So, we advance temp1 over here. Temp1 over here. And ask again a question. Is temp1 of link not equal to null? Now, presently temp1 of link is not null, false. Since it is false, we do not advance temp2 over here. Why? Because we want last but one node's address in a pointer. So that using this, I can break this link. Presently, this link is having the base address 3000 in it. But if this is has to be made the last node, this is to be made the last node, this has to be replaced from 3000 to null. Isn't it? How can I replace this with null unless I do not have a pointer? So, therefore, I am making a shadow pointer called as temp2. So, what I do, I temp2 is equal to null and bring this null over here. Now, this becomes the last node. That's how I delete the last node. So, this is the algorithm. Now, let's convert this algorithm into the code. Right? Temp1 is equal to first, temp2 is equal to first. Keep writing also. If first of first equal to null, presently it is false as you have seen it in the diagram. As you have seen in the diagram, there are three nodes. So first is particular false, so it won't go over here. Then it comes to if temp1 of link equal to equal to null. It is quite possible. There is only one node. Temp1. See, this is the case when there are no nodes. This is the case when there is only one node. When there is only one node, temp1 of link will be equal to null. Right? So, delete element is temp1 of data first is equal to null, free temp1 and return. Yes? So, we should ensure that we cater our logic to all possibilities. First possibility, first if condition when there are no nodes. Second possibility, there is only one node. So that no one node is the first node, last node and temp1 and temp2 also. Right? So temp1 of link will be null. So we delete that. First is equal to null. Make it zero. Not zero, make it null. And we free temp1. We free temp1. Now we come to the while loop when temp1 of link not equal to null. Temp1 is equal to temp1 of link. We have advanced the temp1, right? So temp2 has taken the temp1's position. In this case, temp1 has taken the next. Again, it has come to the while loop. The second node's link is not equal to null. True. Temp2 has taken temp1's place. So temp2 has advanced to node number 2. Temp1 has advanced to node number 3. Right? Again, we have come up. Now, temp1 of link. Remember the node 3? Node 3, temp1 of link is equal to null. So, it is false. When it is false, what we do? Temp2 of link, we make it null. Last is equal to temp2 and free temp1. And free temp1. This is exactly diagrammatically I explained in the last slide, and the equivalent code is this. Please complete the writing. Please complete this code. Assuming that you have finished with this code, now come to the display function. Display and the main. what is the display function is simple. I'd already shown you. So char is equal to first, while char not equal to null, print char of data, advanced char is equal to char of link, and keep on going over here. Neelam, you want the previous slide? Neelam, let me know once you finish. Not temp 2. Why should it be temp 2? It should be temp 1 only. Because temp 1 had advanced to the last node. See, temp 2 of link is equal to null. So if we delete temp 2, we cannot make last is equal to temp 2. So we are freeing temp 1. After freeing temp 1, if you free temp 2, it's not a problem. Reason being, already last is equal to temp 2. Therefore, then after the free temp 1, you can also free temp 2 because we have already assigned temp 2 to the last. Why first is equal to null in second? Where is first equal to null? Saitya, see, in the second if condition is what? When there is only one node. Saitya, when there is only one node, right? When there is only one node, your first, your temp 1, your temp 2 are pointing to that only one node. Okay, so that single node has to be deleted, right? The single node has to be deleted. So before I delete, I print out, I write the data in that this thing, then make first is equal to null. Make first equal to null and free temp 1. So there are two ways. One, either you free first also, or you say first is equal to null. Means what? Whatever was the address in the first, you are reducing it to null. And free temp 1. See, when you do free temp 1, actually the value which was there in temp 1, it becomes null. So there are both the ways you can do it. You can say free first, right? Like you have done free temp 1, or you equate this first to null and remove that whatever address which was there in the first with null. Saitya? Somebody had stopped me in the previous slide. I take it that you are done. I'm going to the next slide. Yeah. Display and the main function. So when you select the first option, you create, second is insert, at the end. Third is insert at the beginning, delete at the beginning, and delete at end. Throw this into ph. And then you write switch case. You write switch case and call the appropriate function based on the value you have entered in, enter your choice. Main function you can complete. Main function you can complete. You know the logic or you know the code. While one is an endless loop, so when the user enters 7, you should write return. The switch case. Right. Case 1, you are calling the create function and display function. So every time I am calling the display function so that the user exactly knows what has happened. If the user enters 2, you are calling the insert function and then in the display function. If you are calling the choice is 3, insert at the beginning and again display. Sorry, this should be insert. Insert is insert at the last and this is insert at the beginning. And if you 5, delete at the end and display, and when you enter 7, exit 0. I think exit 0 does not work in Dev Plus, so you just say return. Exit 0 doesn't work in Dev C++, so replace that with return. Students, please hurry up because I have to close the class at 2:30. There are strict instructions that we should finish the class because other class is scheduled. If you are not take the screenshot. Aitya, please take the screenshot.